What's up, guys? This is DJ Gelo. I'm number 2 in the leaderboard in Puerto Rico, and globally I'm 1,319.
Hello, guys. My name is KS-Pon-21, and I am in Puerto Rico, the number 3, and globally I am 1,576.
Hey. I'm SuzSuz, the number 4 ranked player on the Puerto Rico Beat Saber Power Ranking, and the top 2.5k global ranked player. Today I'm here to give you a tutorial on Beat Saber ranking and improving as a player. So, this video might seem a bit long, within the 15 to 20 minute range most likely, but that's because we cover a lot of things during this video that will help. This includes how to rank, how to act on maps, which is short for accuracy, how to play faster speed maps, and how the ranking system works within itself. So, for those who only come here for a certain part of the video, I'll leave a timetable right here, so you can go to that specific part without having to listen to the whole video or skim through it trying to figure it out. So now that all that info is out of the way, let's begin! First segment is general things. And the first thing I'd recommend to any person trying to get ranked or improve in Beat Saber is to look into other grips. Custom grips will allow you to play with maximum performance and comfortability depending on your preferences and your hand size. Many players across the globe have made grips which are widely accepted by the community and from all headsets, such as the Oculus Rift CV1, the HTC Vive, the Oculus Rift S, the Oculus Quest, the Valve Index, and even Windows Mixed Reality headsets. All of the grips have their pros and cons, so you just have to mess with them until you find one that suits you. But make sure you give them some days while you get used to them, because they will not feel normal when you first start. So, I'm not a doctor, but it's pretty safe to say that you have to make sure to hydrate yourself often while playing Beat Saber, as Beat Saber counts as a workout, so you will be using up a lot of water inside your body, especially on quicker maps, and if you dehydrate yourself, it's not going to be a good time. Also, make sure you're playing in favorable conditions so you won't dehydrate by sweat too quickly. You also have to make sure that you practice in order to self-improve. Beat Saber is truly a game where you get better by playing. It sounds cliche, but it's generally agreed on by the community that it's the way the game was designed. Therefore, the more you play, the better you'll get. Most top players have over 600 hours, and competently ranked players will have at least 100. So make sure you play a lot. And take your time as well. Because playing a lot leads to improvement, but you also gotta be patient. You can't just jump from a 1-hour session to a 3-hour session without any middle ground or preparation, because your body will get fatigued and will burn out. Make sure to also rest between songs as you would in between normal exercise, and make sure to take break days so your body can get used to playing constantly. That was all for the general section. So now we're gonna go into the technical part of how the ranking system itself works, and this is also very important if you want to start gaining performance points. The main basis for ranking in this game is Score Saber. Score Saber is a website run by the Cube community staff that records all scores and ranks from players. The website has global rankings and country ranks, along with every custom song's leaderboard. In order to get ranked, you need to download the Beat Saber mod assistant and download the mods necessary, such as custom songs and the Score Saber mod. You can search yourself by typing your username on the platform you play, that being Steam or Oculus, and you should appear on the results. Remember that not all maps will give you PP. In order to gain PP, you have to play officially ranked songs. One way to get them is by entering the game with mods installed, selecting the mods tab in the main menu, clicking on more songs followed by sort, score Saber, and then ranked. Upon which you will have a huge list of ranked maps. You can also find a ranked song from any source and search it up individually inside the game. So, as for PP, after you beat a ranked map, you will see how much PP you have obtained from it. The PP on a specific play is calculated by the accuracy you get on that map and the difficulty that map is rated at. Although the exact formula is kept hidden to prevent people from making songs that will generate too much PP. Not all PP is worth the same. This prevents pros from grinding super easy maps and creating huge gaps of PP in between players. So the amount of PP you get after beating a song, which you can see in blue, will be known as the total PP, and the amount that will go into your total score will be known as the weighted PP. The weighted PP is calculated by gathering the total PP amount and multiplying it by the curve of 0.965 to the x minus 1. The X represents the position that scores among your top plays, such as your top first play or the third or fourth one. So, therefore, your top play is worth 100% of the raw PP, while your second one will be worth less, such as 97%, for example, and the percent will keep diminishing through the songs. Every new score will move any scores under it down, and so any song you play will fluctuate the weighted PP from most of your profile. Now that you know this, how do you get the max PP possible? If we follow the logic of weighted PP, it is reasonable to make only top plays, so they are worth more of their total points. While this is effective, it can also be tiring and frustrating, and you play levels that are out of your playing skill at the moment. Thankfully, there is a website that will choose the best songs for you to play based on your score saver profile. The link will be in the description. And don't forget to play maps that you've beaten previously from time to time in order to get better scores. And don't always focus on getting top scores, as the small scores will always count as well. So now that we finished with the ranking system part, let's go towards accuracy. So now, let's start with the accuracy segment. A lot of people don't play accuracy or just skip out on them. It is common for people to do so because of the low PP they get for the time you play in a level. But remember that low PP always counts in the long run and is helpful. Now, why is accuracy so important, you may ask? Well, accuracy can make huge differences in higher, faster PP maps, so having your body previously trained to do better slices will really help. An example can be given by comparing some of the scores on Nirvana amongst the top Puerto Rican players, with some small accuracy differences but some pretty notable PP differences. So how may you act, one might say? Well, accuracy is based on three main factors: the swing angle, the timing of the cut, and the cut itself. For the swing angle, make sure you have a 100 degree pre-swing and a 60 degree after-swing. This will guarantee a minimum cut score of 100 points. The other 15 points are based on the timing and cut. For timing, you can just base it off the music's beat for most well-mapped songs. And for the cut, you need to have a clean middle cut from the entry to the center of the cube of the direction it was pointing towards, for example. If it was pointing upwards, make sure your entry is from the bottom side and goes straight to the middle of the cube, as that will be what counts for the cutting score. Other tips I can give for accuracy is that you can cut diagonal blocks as if they were horizontal. This is due to the hitboxes of the cubes being much bigger than the cubes that you can see, so cutting horizontally will still hit the center. You can give this a try and you will see that it really helps, but you gotta get used to it. Another tip is to hit the blocks on the middle lanes as close to the hilt as possible. This will mean you have the most control because it is the closest to your hands. Now, for the different types of accuracy. There are three general types that people consider. These are true accuracy, in which the notes are pretty slow and allow time to focus on every single cut individually, resulting in crazy high accuracies you can see from people like SFK and Pandita. There are standard accuracy maps, which have a bit more speed but simple patterns that flow with the songs, which can also be seen on the high 98s and 97s by pros. And then there are the technical maps that, while they follow the flow, they have pretty complicated patterns to act. These are generally given within the 95 to 96 accuracy range by the professionals. So, that's all I have to say about accuracy at the moment. So just make sure to take your time and practice, and it will help a lot more than you realize it could. Now, let's head on to the part that most people will probably be interested in, which is speed maps. So, speed maps are simpler to explain than accuracy, but that doesn't mean doing speed is easy. You need a lot of patience and practice. So, the biggest help for a speed map is to use your wrists instead of your entire arms or forearms while moving the sabers. It will make it easier and therefore faster, as a wrist is a small joint compared to the large muscles you have to move when using your entire arm. And this also will reduce how fast you get tired. Twixy, the top Puerto Rican player and number 164 ranked as of the recording of this audio, he's an absolute monster, but stated the following about speed maps. So basically, a lot of speed maps are actually quite simple pattern-wise. They just look very dense. You just kind of have to feel the music and swing whenever there is a loud sound. Also, you have to feel comfortable with the speed as well, so try to practice higher BPM songs, such as above 260. As stated, density is the main difficulty faced by new players. The sheer amount of cubes is hard for the brain to process and act accordingly on time. A way to combat this is by looking towards the back of the lane, so you have more time to process all of the cubes that are coming towards you. The more you play these types of maps, the more recognizable the patterns will get as well, and therefore it will make it easier to hit the patterns if you already know which patterns it will be in the first place. And as cliche as it is, the most important factor towards speed will also be practicing. You have to play faster maps. Twixy himself said that when you're confident, try going for higher BPM maps until you can eventually get faster. And that's all that I have to say about speed. Now that you know more about how ranking is done, it is very apparent that improving is mostly about practice and the different facets of what makes a good play. This is often time consuming and aggravating, so avoid playing the same level too many times if you can't pass it. Just play other maps and come to it later another day. The biggest problem from this game is burnout. This is normal, and if you get burnout, make sure to take a break from the game until you feel enthusiastic again. Don't rush the break. Make sure the break is as long as you need it to be. Don't worry about your score. Don't worry about anything. Just relax and come back to it another time. There are also ways to prevent burnout, such as playing non-ranked maps for fun and different kinds of challenge maps. Taking care of your body in and out of VR also helps a lot in preventing burnout. But as always, the most important part is to make sure you're having fun in the game. If you're playing the game but don't enjoy it, it's not worth it. So now that you know all the basics to ranking and improving, go ahead and see where the path takes you. You never know what may happen. Once more, if you want more detailed descriptions from the different categories I have in this video, or order categories outside of ranked, make sure to check the Beat Saber analysis series run by top player Snowy on the Cube Community channel. Links will be in the description. Goodbye!